principal researcher of a multinational corporation, Chris Tong, and her husband bought their first home in Beijing 6 years ago, and a second in 2007. The decision of buying two properties in 3 years, especially in the Chinese capital, which has seen house prices quadruple, is not an easy one to make.
我当时在这边，在北京，我看房子就看了大概三天吧，我就看中了这套房子。然后那时候办贷款需要的时间比较长，好像大概需要3个月的时间。现在的话，好像三天就能办下来。然后另外一套房子呢，是2007年的年底的时候，就是当时是北京的一个也是炒房的一个高峰期，就是在那几年那个在2007年年底，应该是这个房价突飞猛进的一段时间，我们买了第二套房子。
After staying here for years, they plan to sell the apartment and buy a bigger one. Though the price of this 96 square meters apartment has gone up to 800,000 ringgit from 190,000 ringgit.House prices elsewhere have also skyrocketed at the same time. Now, they may have to settle with an apartment for 1.8 million ringgit.
是啊，那个价钱确实很贵。但是随着现在房价越来越高，就这些年来说，已经一次又一次的把我的这个 expectation 改变了。比如说，我原来接受不了2万块钱以上的房子，现在我觉得2万块钱的房子并不贵了。
我想买一个3万块钱左右的房子，对我来说，我应该是我的 target。就是我的目标是在那大概130平米，有3个 bedroom， 所以这样子的话对于我来说我可以自住，同时我也相信在北京的房价在未来的几年，如果我是在一些 hot area， 包括比如说望京啊，然后还有四环或者是五环之间啊那样的地方，我买一套130平米的房子3万块钱买回来，我相信我不会亏的。
The couple is among those fortunate enough to land properties in Beijing when prices were still at affordable levels. Last year, this popular Chinese TV drama, which is about a young couple living in a small house and struggling to buy their dream home as house prices in the city continue to rise, became an overnight hit with many low and middle income earners who go through what the characters do.
开始播剧了吗？角色里面的一样的，
我可能比较像吧，应该都比较像，刚大学刚毕业不久。
你有看过蜗居吗？
看了，太现实了，那没房的工薪阶层都买不起房，
说不出来，因为没细看，你估计应该是有点类似。
有类似。
对，
大概住在多少平方米？
十几米吧，十几平方米。
自己本身有没有自己的房子呢？
没有。
哦，为什么呢？
没钱呗。
没钱啊，
对，刚才工作不久。
买房子难吗？
那当然难了，都工薪阶层，那可不难吗？
目前为止，你有没有自己的房子呢？
没有。
为什么呢？
为什么？这是好多中国人都没有房子。
现在你储钱的这个速度对吧？很快就可以买房了吗？
两三年内根本不可能的。
大概要多久？
大概很难说吧，这个基本上在这边吃饭、住房、租房吧，算是已经所剩无几吧，也剩不了多少钱。
想买房子，肯定很多人都想买。那现在这个水平达不到。
Following the housing reform in China in the early 1980s, the Chinese government put a stop to the house distribution system based on welfare benefits.Instead of living at a house allotted by the company for which they work, Chinese had been given more options. They could buy up the house allotted to them or buy other residential units when the housing market was fully commercialized in 1998. The reform saw a surge in private ownership among the rich people in China.
The fact that a lot of people are investing in real estate in China as a form of savings, it's a worry. First of all, because it bids up the price of housing overall. It crowds out people who actually want a place, affordable place to live. The second thing it does is it skews the development market, that the houses that are being developed are, instead of being affordable housing for people to actually live in, it's high-end villas or condos for people to invest in.The other thing is that it's a potentially unstable source of demand. And if people were to lose faith in the property market, or if some of the dynamics in the property market were to change, there would be a glut of housing on the market and prices would crash.
The craze of local governments using the booming real estate market to spur economic development has caused an unhealthy development in the sector, benefiting mostly developers and minority rich people, and depriving ordinary citizens of homes. Local governments are happy with the way the momentum of the housing market develops, as revenues from land transfers in major cities have brought in for them 800 billion ringgit last year, up 60% from 2008. Record-breaking land transaction sales, loose regulations for bank loans and land auctions, and continuous cash inflow into the market have pushed house prices in 70 major cities 9.5% higher, with some cities even registering 30 to 50% increase year on year.
这个幅度不能说正常，它里面包含着不正常因素，但是全国算在一起，它确实是这样一个情况。它的不正常的因素就是一线城市上涨的过快。一线城市里边你也得分不同地段的啊，同样是在广州，同样是在北京，有的地段它上涨的可能还要30%-50%，有的地段呢可能也比较低，有些楼盘的上涨的情况是上午下午不同价啊，那个上涨的幅度是十分惊人的。
不能否认我们的城市的政府，他们乐观土地价格的上涨和房价的上涨，因为这确实会给地方财政增加很多收入。房价过高过快上涨会引起不稳定，因此现在中央政府采取了几项措施，作为你地方政府加快保障性住房建设和抑制房价过快上涨，是你地方的一个很重要的任务，你必须得完成。
In the next clip, we will see how the Chinese government controls the rising house prices and ensures homes are affordable to everybody.